welcome to the 15th International Coral Reef Symposium, the ICRS here in Bremen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bremen is a city of science. Today, about 30% of all marine research in Germany is located in Bremen and Bremerhaven.
Well, it's been a long time coming. We've been waiting 3 years to have this conference.
Coral reefs are in dire straits.
The ocean needs a stronger voice.
We know what needs to be done.
Coral reef science has really started moving in a direction of how do we make a difference? How do we find solutions? What are the solutions?
The bad news about coral reefs can be overwhelming.
Our beloved coral reefs are dying fast in front of our eyes.
Now, this is a crisis for corals and all the organisms associated with them. It is a crisis for the many people that depend directly on coral reefs. And it's also a crisis for all of humanity.
It's the rate of change which is the problem.
And we know what we need to be doing to fix that.
Solutions do exist.
Reducing carbon emissions and limiting warming is absolutely essential.
Climate change mitigation is the most important issue because the carbon dioxide removal capacity of ecosystems on land and in the ocean, they cannot do it all.
But we also need to get things right locally and regionally.
Because even if the climate is stable, if there's overfishing or pollution, that too can kill coral reefs. In fact, before climate change became a big problem, it was killing large numbers of reefs.
But we can make things less bad, and we can do things through conservation, management, protection, innovation.
We are looking into helping corals to reproduce successfully, to adapt to a changing environment. You know, there is hope and there is optimism.
Microbes can be considered medicine to protect corals as probiotics that can increase their resilience. We need to work together to advance the science while we still have time.
The next few decades are a real bottleneck and critical for the future of the oceans.
The key is that we leverage the existing genetic diversity that we still have in our coral populations, because that will be the fuel that allows for adaptation of corals to a rapidly changing climate.
Don't be scared to think about how reefs are now operating differently. Think about what the changes to coral reefs mean. What do they mean for management and what do they mean for humans?
Any solutions we might seek to the coral reef crisis and to the biodiversity crisis is really about people. Research and conservation projects ought to be co-created or in support of and done in partnership with indigenous and local peoples.
As scientists, we go beyond just science. We don't have the luxury of staying within a scientific bubble and not sharing that more broadly because coral reefs are in such a crisis and we are working against the clock.
We all have to come into the middle. The scientists on the one hand, the policymakers on the other.
Keeping to the Paris Agreement and the climate targets is the most important precondition for saving the world's coral reefs.
We have to be optimistic. Don't give up. Don't give up.
Something big happened this week. We received a lot of attention from the public and decision makers. The media interest was outstanding.
Some highlights from this week include our first female Darwin medalist, Dr. Nancy Knowlton. We had over 1,000 in-person participants, more than 270 virtual participants.
Congratulations for the first climate neutral ICRS in history.
At least 50% of all the participants, chairs, plenary speakers, and panelists are females.
It was the first ever held in Europe and the largest marine science conference ever held in Germany. Thank you.